We start with one of our chart. Just I want to give a quick update. First of all, if you refer to our analysis in my last video, when the price was exactly within this move, we mentioned we're looking for buy. And we had these targets since the price was within this move. The first target is 40, following by second one, 42.8. Okay, as we can see, we have been looking for buy and the price, it takes the first take profit, all right? But after that, I didn't have any trades, any update for analysis. And right now we have this one. We want to see how we can look for trade. Anyway, whoever get the trade from this, at least if they still keep the trade, move their stop loss to break even, because the price almost break the first target, but after the breakout, the price couldn't take the second target, right? Because in our analysis, we mentioned if then the price take second target, then we can move our stop loss to first target, at least book profit. Anyway, if anyone is still keep the trade from this, at least move their stop loss to break even. Now we move to higher time frame. We want to see what we have. Based on daily chart, the only thing says we want to see whether we can get the correction here, because we want to see the continuation. We want to see whether the price can break 45 or not. Okay. Anyway, we move to lower time frame. We move to forward chart. And even based on forward chart, we're looking at this correction. We want to see whether we can get how deep it can be, because we want to put this one in relative to this. But the only thing says, from what we get sharp move down, we can expect this one can give us one more drop. At least we can, similar to, as I said, we can expect this one turn to a deeper correction before we get the next move, because we were expecting the price to break the previous top. Price broke, but it couldn't continue. And now we're looking for the next one, is 42. All right, that's why we can expect this one turn to a deeper correction before we get the next move, all right? But anyway, we don't have any trade set up. And if I move to 1 hour chart, we want to see how we can look for trade. As I explained, based on forward chart, the best thing is if this one gives us one more drop. Then from there, any reversal, we can look for trade, at least with the breakout of this low. And if we get one more drop with the breakout of this low, any reversal, we can look for trade, or we can have entry above this. But how about if the price continue from here? Still, we can look for trade. But if this one continues a corrective move, we are not going to look for trade. The only way, if we get a sharp move with the breakout of this, like we take the trade. Having entry above this, it can be an option, but it's really risky. But still, I prefer, I think this one can retest this low. Then from there, we can look for trade. Okay, how about if I move to 15 minutes? We don't have any things to discuss. And the only thing is, maybe we can put this two in relative to each other. You get 1, 2, 3. And right now, still, we can expect this one give us a one more walk. But the best thing is still I'm looking to get the one more drop. And as I mentioned, still we can expect this one continue as a corrective. But if there is a continuation as a corrective, we are not interested to look for trade. We are looking for the sharp move. Anyway, we don't have a really good trade setup. In this case, we just follow the chart. If I see any update, I will share. And right now we're looking at this correction. We want to see how deep it can be. Anyway, if I see any option, any update, I will share. Thanks.